Intermittent fasting is about breaking that pattern. Let's see if we can make some different choices in our day to stop doing that. So the first thing I ask people to do is when they finish their meal at night, around 7 o'clock-ish, you know, an hour here or there, doesn't really matter, but around 7 o'clock, stop. Do not consume more calories until you break your fast the next day, around 12 hours. If you want to have water, something that doesn't have calories in it, you can. Give yourself about 12 hours of no food. Just try starting with that. That is one way, the very simplest way of practicing intermittent fasting. If you want to take the next step from there, then I would suggest beginning with your in-between meals during the day. Don't consume something with sugar in it all day long. Don't consume snacks throughout your day. Get rid of the crackers, get rid of the chips, get rid of those things. Get rid of the rice cakes, for Pete's sake. Those are the worst possible. The one grain that is as close to glucose as possible is rice. It's 95% the same as glucose. So when you're eating your no-fat, healthy birthday cake flavored rice cakes, all you're doing is you're eating straight glucose. So put them down. If you need to snack on something, you can snack on nuts. If you've got a refrigerator available, maybe some olives or dill pickles, just a few, you know, small handful, that's great. And your body will be satisfied. If you need something with caffeine in it, you can get a Coke Zero or a Dr. Pepper Zero going. For those of you concerned about artificial sweeteners, I have videos about that. Artificial sweeteners are definitely not the problem the way sugar is. And the current science on them is that there may be some correlations, which are certainly not causation. So it's not the area we have to worry about. Pick something that doesn't have an artificial sweetener in it, but stay away from sugar. If you will develop that pattern where you have 12 hours at night that you're fasting, and in between your meals, you're not continually consuming calories, you're gonna notice an amazing change in your body within days. You'll notice that you don't crash as much, you don't get sleepy and tired as much, you don't have as much brain fog, you sleep better at night, and most people within a month period of time are gonna report 2 to 5 pounds of weight loss. That's just from backing away from all the food. And it's not complicated, and you don't have to read a whole book about it, and you don't have to put an app on your phone to give you alarms to tell you when you do or don't eat. Now, if you want to take the next step to intermittent fasting, I have several patients that have made the life commitment to fast 18 hours every day. So really what they're down to is 2 meals. And as long as they're getting all the other nutrients they need, there is no problem with this. You just gotta make those 2 meals count. But once a week, if you wanted to go 18 hours, you know, don't eat from 6 or 7 at night until 12 the next day, that's fine, no problem. Every night, 12 hours, once a week, 18 hours. You can occasionally push that to 24. But again, we're keeping it simple and something that you know when you're doing it, you know what you're doing, you don't require any extra tools or any other reminders. The last level of fasting for people who are really well along their nutrition and health journey that I do recommend from time to time is a weekend fast. The first time you do this, you might wanna just do a 24 or 36 hour fast, but eventually you can work up to where you stop eating Friday night and you don't eat again until Sunday night. And I'm not gonna dive into that right now, I'm just telling you that's possible. There's a way to get there and there are additional benefits for your health for doing it like this. But keep it simple. The more complex it gets, the more committed you have to be to do it, and the more consistent the rest of your life has to be. I do not recommend complex things for families with small children, for people who work a wide variety of schedules. The more variables in your life, the simpler you want your nutrition approach to be.